and welcome to Inside Science. Guys, very less days are remaining to go for prelims 2020. So our main focus is to focus on those areas which are highly ignored, just like science and technology, environment, etc. So let's start with the first issue, that is 70th Constitutional Day. So guys, actually in 26th November 1949, the Constituent Assembly of India adopted the Constitution of India, and it came to into force on 26th January 1950. Jammu and Kashmir will celebrate it for the first time since the abrogation of Article 370, so that it was in news. So what is the aim of it? To publicize the glorious and rich composite culture and diversity of our nation, to create awareness of fundamental duties as enshrined in the Indian Constitution, to reiterate and reorient the citizens towards the values and principles expressed in the Indian Constitution, to encourage all Indians to play their rightful role in strengthening Indian democracy. So the next issue is Smog Tower in Delhi. A smog tower is being planned for the National Capital Region, that is NCR Delhi, to create a clean air zone in the region. The smog tower is one of the devices to control air pollution in NCR Delhi. It is expected to reduce particulate matter by 50% in the area. The filters being installed would use carbon nanofibers as a major component. So this carbon nanofibers are very important. The proposed smog tower is focused only on reducing particulate matter load at the present. It will majorly help to reduce the severity of the air pollution in NCR Delhi. So these smog towers are structures designed to work as large-scale air purifiers. They are usually fitted with multiple layers of the air filters, which clean the air of pollutants as it passes through them. Guys, remember, China has the world's largest smoke tower and has reduced PM2.5 by 19% in an area of around 6 square kilometers in the tower's vicinity. The next issue is Ken Betwa River Interlinking Project. Guys, before that, I will show something. This Ken Betwa lies in between the states of Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Guys, remember, this is your Ken River. This is your Betwa River. Okay, so and this is your Bundelkhand region. So we are trying to interlink those two rivers so that the Bundelkhand region will have a greater benefit. The 18,000 crore project has been mired in several hurdles. The most recent one is disagreement between the states on the share of water. There are outstanding environmental obstructions too. It involves deforesting a portion of Panna Tiger Reserve, and this is important. The country's first river interlinking project is the Ken Betwa interlinking project. Okay, so the project aims to transfer surplus water from the Ken River in the MP to Betwa River in UP to irrigate the drought-prone Bundelkhand region spread across, this is Bundelkhand region, spread across the district of two states, mainly Jhansi, Banda, Lalitpur, Mohoba districts of UP, and Tikamgarh, Panna and Chhatrapur districts of MP. So let's discuss in details. This is your Ken River, as I mentioned, and this is your Betwa River, and this canal link is there so that the water balance would be maintained between two rivers, and the project will also benefit UP and MP in terms of meeting their irrigation and drinking water needs, and it can create hazards in future. The project involves deforesting a portion of the Panna Tiger Reserve. This Panna Tiger Reserve is very, very important. Always remember, the Panna Tiger Reserve is always interlinked to Ken Betwa River Interlinking Project. Okay, so let's move to the next key facts to this. It is not next issue. This is the key facts regarding Ken Betwa Interlinking Project. This Ken and Betwa rivers originate in MP and are the tributaries of Yamuna. This Ken and Betwa, both rivers are the tributaries of Yamuna. So guys, in comment box mention what is the origin of Yamuna, from which glacier Yamuna river originates. Ken meet with Yamuna in Banda district of UP and with Betwa in Hamirpur district of UP. Rajghat, Paricha and Matatila dams are over Betwa River. Ken River passes through Panna Tiger Reserve. Again, it is important. Ken River passes through. If in exam they are asking Betwa River passes through Panna Tiger Reserve, it is wrong. Ken River passes through Panna Tiger Reserve. One question was asked pertaining to that in 2016. Not many years ago, river linking was a concept, but it is becoming reality in the country. Discuss the advantage of river linking and its possible impact on the environment. So let's move to the next issue, that is Panna Tiger Reserve. In this interlinking manner, if we are covering the issue, it will greatly benefit to you. The tiger reintroduction project in Panna Tiger Reserve has completed a decade, making it one of the best models of conservation in the world. So guys, in comment box mention which tiger reserves are located in Madhya Pradesh. The Panna Tiger Reserve is situated in the Vindhya mountain range in the northern part of Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh has the highest number of tigers in the country. This Ken River, a tributary of Yamuna River, flows through the reserve. The region is also famous for Panna diamond mining. This Ken Betwa River interlinking project will be located within the Tiger Reserve. So the next issue is Assam roofed turtle, and in previous lecture already we have covered olive ridley turtle, and in comment box mention which protection status has been given to this olive ridley status in IUCN. So mention in the comment box. See, Assam roofed turtle, that is also known as Pangshura silhetensis, is a small freshwater turtle, and its habitat or niche is primarily in running waters in the hills of northeastern India and northeastern and southeastern Bangladesh. So its IUCN status is endangered. It is the most important part, and in sites it is mentioned in Appendix 2, and it is India's Wildlife Protection Act 1972. The turtle has been covered under Schedule 1 of this EPA 1972. So the next issue is coal bed methane, CBM. And on which context it was in news? Because Ministry of Coal has asked the state-run coal miner Coal India Limited to produce 2 MMSCB, that is million metric standard cubic meters per day of coal bed methane gas in the next 2 to 3 years. Let's have an economy question. This Coal India Limited is Maharatna, Miniratna or Navratna, whatever you know, mention in the comment box. I want to know about all those Navratnas, Miniratna and Maharatna. These are very, very important things, and Google on it and you can have a great knowledge on that. So this CBM potential, India has the 5th largest coal reserves in the world, and CBM been looked at as a clean alternative fuel with significant prospects. The country's coal and CBM reserves are found in 12 states in India, with the Gondwana sediments of the eastern India holding the bulk. This Gondwana sediments is the keyword, remember it. The Damodar Coal Valley and Son Valley are prospective areas of CBM development, that is coal bed methane. So let's discuss in details what is this coal bed methane. It is an unconventional form of natural gas. Found in coal deposits or coal seams. CMB is formed during the process of coalification, the transformation of plant material into coal. Sorry, this is not CMB, this is CBM, coal bed methane. This CBM can be used in power generation, compressed natural gas autofuel, as feedstocks to fertilizers, industrial uses such as in cement production, rolling mills, steel plants, and for methanol production. What are those challenges and concerns? Methane is a greenhouse gas emitted through CBM extraction. Global methane emissions from coal mines are projected to account for approximately 8% of total global methane emissions, and it can create ecosystem damage in long run. So let's discuss the prelims 2017 prelim question. Recently, there was a proposal to translocate some of the lions from their natural habitat in Gujarat to which of the following sites? Options are Korbet National Park, Kunna Palpur Wildlife Sanctuary, Mudumalai Wildlife Sanctuary, Sariska National Park. The answer is Kunno Palpur Wildlife Sanctuary. Guys, why I am giving this kind of questions? Because it will inculcate a sense of, which kind of questions are coming in prelims, so that you can prepare well for that. So the next question which was asked in prelims 2019 was that, which of the following statements are correct about the deposits of methane hydrate? The options available are, global warming might trigger the release of methane gas from the deposits. Large deposits of methane hydrate are found in Arctic tundra and under the seafloor. Both 1 and 2 are correct. And the third option is, methane in atmosphere oxidizes to carbon dioxide after a decade of 2. So option 3 also right. The right option is answer D. So thank you guys. Have a nice day.